Okay, so there are going to be some changes in my life, and honestly, it's quite jarring in the offset. But like, sometimes you just have to just cut a line under whatever has gone on and move on with your life. Sometimes that's just what you have to do. And the saddest part about all of this is that, thinking back on reflection, no one actually cared. No one actually gave a rise with it. And it's like, that's the norm. It's weird how it's a no one, not to give a F-C-U-K. It's weird how it's just so normal. And it's mesmerizing how I survived all of it and I still remain true to myself, but it's like, it's sad. It's just sad. All I want to do is like bring sunshine to people's lives, and they thoroughly want to beat it out of you because it'll be out of them, and then, you know, you have to pass the book, right? God. It's actually weird. It's weird. And it's true what I said to a friend earlier. I said that I didn't get upset anymore, and that is 1000% correct. Because why should I? Because plus come to shove, this was probably going to happen anyway. Plus come to shove, you're probably the person who you are. Plus come to shove, why should I? I've got more important things to do than to be upset about you. And I'm not saying you right now, but you see, this is why English needs to have different pronouns other than like you. And you, like, what is it? Vous and two? I'm not head space right now. But like, people thoroughly didn't give a damn. And it's like, are you okay? Because like, for me, wanting to evoke happiness into other people's lives is so innate and so natural. I must be an empath, but it's just bizarre. All in bizarre. So, baby doll, if you find out that you are cut out of my personal life, then take it personally. There's something wrong with you, and I need to move onwards and upwards. And I didn't have the time nor patience for anyone's BS any longer. Oh, why is this happening? Figure it out. I didn't know why. Okay. Then learn. And learn. And people want to claim that I come across as rude or angry. No. You know that's not true. You know that I'm just a person who doesn't want to absorb your BS. That's all it is. And you are afraid that you lived life with these rainbow tinted glasses, thinking that you can bend everyone to your whim. And you met me and it's like, actually, no. I want this today. And for some reason people want to claim that's difficult or, oh, that's kind of nonsense. It's not. Someone who's difficult is someone who's like, oh, I don't know what I want. Maybe I want this, maybe I want this. But if you have someone who walks up to you, like, saying, like, hello, can I please have this? Thank you. Suddenly, it's rude? No. No. And as jarring as it may be, I know for a fact I'll be happier, healthier. Jumping into the other side. I know that for a fact. And the only way to get happier is to raise your standards. It's like, if you want to continue to talk to someone that way, then talk to someone else. And it's just funny. Looking back, I just have to laugh. Because, like, have to laugh. Oh well, oh well, oh well. And it's not like, England is a weird country. It is. Britain is very weird because it's not like people would happily guide you towards who you want to be. It's almost like they force you, you're going to be upon you. It's like, okay, you're this today. It's like, no, actually, I can be whatever I want to be. And then for some reason they want to get all of their feelings and everything. It's like, ugh, goodness me. Like, I do want to be here for, I mean, I might go back to university or I might just like jump the gun and go straight to the US. Or Europe or somewhere. But like, I'm just tired of it. I am. And it's like, and you can get it too if you want. That's enough for everyone. There really is, but I guess I don't know. I mean, I may be heading towards a simping ship myself, and it's like, well, if you didn't hear about the Titanic sinking, if you just didn't pick up the newspaper that day, would you still regret not going on the Titanic? Like, profound as hell, yeah. I mean, but the thing is, I'd rather jump into the fire than be cold-hearted.